So this Target exclusive NECA Alien Ripley jumpsuit, Alien 40th Anniversary Edition, wow, what a mouthful, is a bit of an update on a previous figure that we've had before. The previous figure is here, and we'll get a comparison to it in just a minute, and we'll look at the differences in the figures. It's principally paint and a little bit of kind of facial scanning and that kind of stuff. But first of all, let's dive in and look at the packaging. So we've got the old classic Kenner logo packaging going on there, and it's done with NECA's logo there in the Kenner style. Not sure how happy Hasbro or Kenner are, but I guess they've got the license to do it. And the old warning that was on the packaging there, and an alien on the box, just red inside, nothing else. We get a picture of Ripley on the side. Really do like this packaging, and please, please, NECA, go back and redo some of the other figures as well. I'd love to see some of the other characters done in a more in their kind of jumpsuits, etc. These three guys look absolutely stunning, and I think it's because they're the soon to be released figures, and they just have a lot of kind of facial scan tech and updates, so can't wait to get them. These are all pretty well, these two actually, these three are pre-orderable on darksidetoys.com, which is where I ordered them. But then I found out this was going to be a Target exclusive. Not quite sure yet on Ash. There's some text if you want a freeze frame. And just another picture of Ripley on the back. And then this side, we just get Alien 40th Anniversary. So it's all a nod to the original packaging. UPC, should you need it. Whoops. There you go. And Randy and the team and the sculpt, Trevor Grove, Adrian Smith. It's looking pretty good. Do like it. So that's the packaging. We get one extra accessory, which I don't think I've ever seen before, which is this little, it looks like a smoke detector or some kind of weird device, but obviously it's a tracking thing from the first movie. And you can see some nice kind of diodes and other bits and pieces put on there. I do like that little kind of piece just there. And there's a few, it's nicely designed, nicely put together, and from memory it looks pretty accurate. I don't remember it quite being as green as this, but there you go. Things happen and change. Doesn't really do anything, it just, yep, it's just, it's all one piece, and she could hold that if you want. I remember it just looking so bloody big and heavy, but it kind of made the part that you reminded the fact that they've cobbled this thing together from parts. So there you go, it's got four little feet on it too. How considerate. There we go. So, and the other thing that was in the case is a little Jonesy. Now we've had Jonesy before, but we've never had a cat carrier to go with him. And you can see he's looking very space age there. Bit of a Union Jack going on, I think, mashed up. And some text there. It says automatic airlock warning. So it's a vacuum packed kitty box. And if you adjust his ears, you can just get Jonesy inside. And it's got a little piece up at the top. You can just make it there. It says hatch and pressure lock there. And if you move that across, you can then take this piece out. And there is Jonesy. And inside is just a kind of padded looking piece. But it's nicely, nicely done. And there is one little kitty. And it kind of reminds you of the scene where Parker and Brett are getting kind of numbed, and the cat, the Ridley Scott, flashes to the cat's eyes, and the cat kind of snarls, a very kind of iconic moment in the movie. It does have articulation. It's got a little pin joint inside there, so you can basically rotate round, and that's about it. It also will give you a little bit up and a little bit down, not much, but it works on that single joint, and that's it. There's no tail or any, is it tail? No. And that is it. Now, we've had previous Jonesys before. The last Jonesy we had was this one. It was absolutely huge. So you can see quite a difference in that Jonesy there, paint-wise. And we had another Jonesy before, which was a more scared version there, which admittedly had slightly better paint. This looks a little Icon Has Cheeseburger-ish. So there you go. Kind of different Joneses. Three different Joneses, as far as I can recall. But this one is new here. So, on with the Ripley. One thing to look at is the previous Ripley, and I should just bring her up here. Previous one on the left, new one on the right. Quite different. Hair looks to be redone overall, and head sculpt too. You can see this tapered down the back into this kind of Just kind of ridiculous looking mop. This one's a lot thinner looking. The figure stands 7 inches or 18 centimeters long. Looks like a goddamn corset here going on at the back. Slight differences in paint. The running shoes that she's wearing. Let me get this out of the way because it's causing the camera to focus. If you look at the training shoes, you can see they're very white on the new version, and the old version they were weathered to death. So you can just see them there. There we go. That's pretty much it. We still get the same Nostromo patch on the side there. Neither are equally great. You can see the shirt underneath, kind of horrible green there. That looks much more accurate. And again, another Nostromo patch or something on the arms. Can't quite. So small, but same on both. But the difference really is that facial sculpt. And I think the sculpt is there. I think they've redone the entire head, actually. They have, yes, the mouth's open there too. So completely redone the head and the face. And some people have been kind of like, well, it's not quite hitting Ripley again. There is some facial scanny tech vibe going on. In certain lights, it just really captures Sigourney Weaver a little bit. But look, we've still got a long way to go. But I'm very, certain moments, it is definitely her. So look, they're definitely trying. And I'm very appreciative because no one else has given Alien some love. So God bless NECA. But at times, I'm like, yeah, it's maybe not the completely best facial sculpt, but it's not bad. And certainly when you compare it to this early effort, it is quite a difference. Just really not hitting the mark at all. So this one is much, much better. In terms of the weapons, exactly the same as the previous one. There really is no difference, just very slight paint differences. Other than that, the tubes are exactly the same. A little bit of slight differences. One is matte, one is shinier. But exactly the same. There's no differences in them. So the Ripley figure really is a bit limited in articulation. It's the same as the old one. You've got that ball joint on a hinge. You can see the ball joint up at the top of the arms. You've got a single joint at the elbows, and you've got a ball joint on the wrists. You've got an ab crunch up at the top there. Pegs up at the top. You can just about see that little ratcheted piece there. Those thigh joints also swivel, so you can get a little movement there. Single joint at the knee and rocking ankles. Well, kind of. It's a peg joint, so you'll get a little bit of movement there, but it's not a great deal. And peg holes, very shallow ones there. And this time round, it's the same. So it's the same figure, back it again, but just with facial scan tech updates, a little bit more accurate paint, and some very nice packaging, and a new Jonesy and cat carrier and other thing, whatever that was. I'm not quite sure again whether we had that green smoke thing before, but I'm sure we did at one point. I keep wanting to call it a smoke dispenser, but you get the point. A tracker, an alien tracker. So if it's for you, then let us know. Leave a note in the comments. We'll put a link underneath where you can go and pick this up. Target exclusive in the US. I think it's sold out, but you may find it in some stores. And also, if you're in Australia, it's at Pop Culture. And some places like Zavvi in the UK, possibly Star Action Figures and others, you might get it there. But I'd pick this one up because it will go, and the old one is no longer wanted. Let us know what you think of this NECA Alien Ripley in her jumpsuit, and we'll see for more reviews and other stuff coming up. Cheers.